So much for supporting, for subscribing, for watching. A lot of you guys that, you know, keep me encouraged and everything. I really, really appreciate you guys. And sometimes I lose interest in filming videos and, you know, doing this kind of stuff, but whenever I remember some of your comments and things like that, I'm like, okay, well, they still want to see her make a video. So yeah, here I am making a video. 2015, another day, another hustle. You just keep doing what you do, try to better yourself every single day and keep moving forward. And as always, keep God in mind, keep working hard, keep praying, keep being humble, and you shall move forward in the name of God. Amen. When I saw a Malibu doll face and Vicky, when I saw their hairstyle, I was like, I love it on them, but I just absolutely hate straight hair on me. It's just not me. You almost never catch me wearing a sleek, long, straight hairstyle, especially in the middle part. I just don't like it on me. But I was like, I'm gonna give it another try and see how it goes. And I'm actually liking it, you know? Middle part, straight, sleek, long, 24 inches. I'm like, heck yeah, I can deal with this. I pretty much went for Peruvian hair because I like how it's like light and airy, flows so nicely, silky with a little bit of texture. Film from start to finish how I achieved this hairstyle. So hopefully you guys find this video helpful, and talk to you all later. Okay, first things first, I'm gonna bleach the knots on the closure, and those are the little black dots on the closure. I'm just doing this because it makes the closure appear more realistic, but this is definitely optional. You don't have to do it. You can like camouflage the closure by applying makeup like concealer or eyeshadow that closely matches your scalp. Actually, this is the first time I'm ever bleaching my own personal closure that I use on my wigs, but you know, it's just an option to like make closures look more realistic and less of a hassle. I'm mixing the developer and the lightener very thick because when I apply it on the lace, I don't want it to run onto the hair. When it's thicker, it just stays like in one place. Wherever you put it, that's where it's gonna stay. And I apply that very lightly with a light hand on top of the lace. I'm gonna list the products that I use in this video in the description section below, so you can check there if you're wondering what I'm using. This step is also optional, but whenever I'm lifting any color that's like dark to a lighter stage, I usually tone it, whether it's lace closure or it's just hair in general. I tone it because, you know, the brassy look that you get from lifting hair color, it's not very attractive in most cases. I just use this toner for the most part whenever I'm toning hair, and I just follow the directions on the packaging and mix it up, applied it on the lace, let it sit for a while, then rinse that off as well.
I've made several wig tutorials already, so for this particular kind of wig, I'm gonna link the full tutorial in the description bar below so you guys can check it out. You can also click the screen right here to be directed to the video if you're watching on like a laptop or desktop or something like that. I'm completely done making the wig, so I go ahead and cold wash it. And I usually cold wash the hair before making the wig, and you know, sometimes afterwards, it really doesn't matter as long as the hair is clean. While the hair is still wet, I'm gonna go ahead and define my parting. It just makes things easier this way and helps the closure lay flatter. At this point, you can do either one of two things. You can let the hair air dry or blow dry it. I decided to go for blow dry because I want the hair as sleek and straight as possible. I applied this heat serum first, and I applied like very little bit because I don't want to apply too much products to this hair and I don't want it to get weighed down or too shiny. Now it's time for some flat ironing. I like to use argan oil because it's very lightweight before flat ironing hair, and it helps give off that natural luster look without looking too shiny, and also protects the hair from heat. To be as flat and smooth as possible, so I'm just using the back side of the iron to do that. You can also use a curling wand if you wish. I really didn't want to cut this hair at all because I just want that straight look. Because of my face shape, I have to cut a little bit of layer towards the front part to frame my face a little bit, and I'm cutting it very lightly. And I also decided to start kind of like low, close to my collarbone, because I don't want it to be too high. Like too high of a layer can start to look funny. I feel like longer layers look better on me, and it's just, you know, easier to deal with too. You can always go shorter or, you know, leave it as is. This is also optional depending on the closure that you're using. When you part some closures, the partings are really narrow and they usually don't look really realistic, and you have to kind of twist them a little bit to widen the parting a little bit because you're trying to make your closure look as realistic as possible. You don't want it to look wiggy or, you know, fake. So what I'm doing right here is just randomly just pulling out some hair from both sides of the parting till you get it wide enough, like kind of close to your own natural parting. Whenever you part your own hair, you just kind of gauge it that way and, you know, get your closure to look as realistic as possible. And you don't want to go too crazy on this either, because you don't want your parting to be too wide, because then it's gonna look like you're losing your hair. Now it's time to try on this bad boy. As usual, I attached an elastic band to help the wig stay more secure, and that's usually enough for me. I don't need combs whenever I use elastic bands, but you can attach combs if you wish. And usually I would cornrow my hair, but I was being too lazy, so I decided to just part my hair in the middle where I would like the wig to sit. Whenever my wig or my closure is sitting right on my hairline, I look crazy, as you can see right here. So once I apply the wig, I shift it back a little bit, not too far back. You don't want it looking like you're just having something sitting on top of your head, just a little bit, slightly. The color of the lace and my own natural parting are not too far from each other, so I can kind of leave the wig looking like this. But if I want to be like extra anal, like just want to perfect it a little bit more, then I'm going to take a little bit of eyeshadow to blend the closure and my own parting together better. Just, you know, where the line of demarcation of my own parting and the closure starts. And the color that, you know, works best for me is the taupe color from the Lorac palette. Just lightly applying it to my scalp and, you know, where the closure starts. And that is all. Hopefully you found this helpful. And don't forget to check the description section of this video for useful links and, you know, list of products used and any other information you might like to know about the video or anything you see in the video, really. So yeah, talk to you guys later. Bye.